your portfolio. Always consult with a qualified investment, legal, or tax professional before taking any action.
You've worked hard and saved for retirement, but remember, it's what you do with that money that really matters. How will you ensure that you wring every nickel out of your Social Security benefits? Could you pay fewer taxes in retirement? And how and when will you withdraw money from your IRA or 401k? Welcome to Secured Retirement Radio with Joe Lucy of Secured Retirement Financial. Joe's a certified financial planner, fiduciary, and a contributor to the Wall Street Journal, and has nearly 25 years of helping people just like you. This is where you can count on straightforward and objective advice on how to make your money go further in retirement. And now, here's your host, Joe Lucy.
Well, so the writing is on the wall. Taxes, they're going higher. Now, it doesn't really matter which side of the political fence you fall on. This is going to be your new reality. And one thing that most people aren't going to be talking about right now is if you're trying to retire in the next couple years, these taxes, well, they could take a huge chunk out of your IRA, 401k, any of these retirement accounts you have, leaving you with just a mere fraction of your retirement savings. Welcome to Secure Retirement Radio. I'm Joe Lucy, Certified Finance Planner. I've got Dylan Malberg joining us in the St. Louis Park Secured Retirement Radio studio. And we've got a great show for you today. Now, you might be thinking, these higher taxes will just impact the most wealthy. They probably won't affect me. But when you consider, well, the collateral damage, the financial fallout from COVID-19 pandemic, this won't just, it can't just impact the most wealthy. It's going to impact all of you hardworking Americans. So it's absolutely essential, it's critical that you start to take proactive steps now to defend your hard-earned savings. So coming up on today's program, why you could be paying a whole lot more in taxes in the near future, plus what you should be doing or what you can do to reduce or eliminate taxes with your retirement savings.
Good morning, Joe.
Morning, Dylan.
Hey, before we, you know, we're going to talk here in this first segment about reasons why taxes are going to go higher. And we've been talking about this on Secure Retirement Radio. We've been talking about it at Secure Retirement with meetings of the families that we've been having here since basically 2018. But if we just look back at the last, you know, 9 months or so, and we look at what's happened here during COVID and the pandemic that we're in, and you look at that first stimulus package that came through the CARES Act there in end of March, what happened, and it's been in the news. We've had this, you know, the $600 checks went out. There's going to be more coming. This massive stimulus that's gone through the economy, again, we were talking about before COVID happened, and you add this onto it, it's the writing's on the wall, right, Joe?
Well, absolutely. And you know, Dylan, well, we've been talking for taxes here at 25 years, over 10 years on Secure Retirement Radio, and how important it is to bring this into your retirement planning. And, you know, I guess that back in 2018, we thought we had a tremendous opportunity. It wasn't until the Tax Act was passed and brought in 2019 that we realized that this fire sale, I don't know if that's the right word, but this was a tremendous opportunity. Well, I guess the election has spoken. So we know that, you know, President Joe Biden has campaigned on higher taxes. Now he's in the middle of a pandemic, so how fast this comes in. But there's no doubt we're going to start to see this. And then we compound that with trillions and trillions of dollars going from the quantitative easing, which maybe hasn't hit the headlines that was going on, and low interest rates, to stimulus package one, PPP one, there's PPP two, there's all of these different stimulus that's going on for hardworking Americans. They're probably the right thing to do, but we're on the heels of some of the largest stimulus packages ever recorded in human history, and there's talks of even more right around the corner. Now, basically, our national deficit, our budget deficit and the national deficit are greater than we have seen. And people, we've all been worried about our debt for some time. Now, at some point, Americans are going to need to start paying back the government. And it's not just necessarily on our federal tax level, that 1040 that gets filed on April 15th, but we're talking about state taxes, local taxes. They need to start finding the revenue, and they're probably going to get a little bit more creative around the taxes. We've already seen that around Medicare and higher premiums for health insurance and these penalties and carve-outs and such that are going to impact us, and they're going to start impacting us even more as we get into retirement. And if you're in this golden decade, if you're between the ages of 59 and a half and 70 and a half, this 10-year period of time where many Americans really start to focus on their retirement savings, and you're going into your retirement planning just focusing purely on what the S&P 500 is, what the 401k balance is, and you're not paying attention to the fact that money in your 401k is not 100% yours. In fact, when you put the money in there, there was a promise paid to the government, a promise made, that said that somewhere down the road you would be paying tax on this balance, and you made this promise knowingly or unwillingly, not sure exactly how much of this was going to be the government's. And if we're in a low tax bracket today, and everybody I've visited with has agreed, we are definitely in a period of time where we are going to start seeing higher taxes. If your retirement plan, if your financial planning, if the investment strategies are the only thing you focus on, and you're not looking at what you need to start doing now to put yourself into a better place long-term financially with taxes, I think you are absolutely going to be missing the boat here long-term.
And you mentioned earlier, President-elect Joe Biden running on these higher, he ran on raising taxes, and now you have a Democratic-controlled Congress, and you know, there's going to be this lack of bipartisan support, the Congress is all Democratic. So you mentioned earlier, hopefully it gets pushed off and it's not their main priority up front because of the pandemic, everything else. But the path to raising taxes has become a lot easier to see, I guess, after the elections here in Georgia a week or so ago.
Well, so we are looking at a national debt here approaching $28 trillion. We have an administration that has promised to remove the current tax that we're under. The Biden administration has stated very publicly that they want to eliminate this as quick as possible. And what a lot of people aren't talking about is they could actually even do this as early as before the end of this month and make it retroactive. So that could be scary too, and not a whole lot we can do about it. But if you're looking out forward, if you are in that golden decade, you're starting to get serious about retirement, you have to recognize taxes are going to be higher and they're just right around the corner. And what most people don't know is that these taxes that we're in right now, well, they're the lowest we've seen in over 40 years. Now, if you take advantage of this window of opportunity we're in and you bring tax planning into your financial planning, there are ways that you can save tens of thousands, if not hundreds of thousands of dollars in taxes in your retirement years. Now, that's why I'd like to make a special offer here this morning just to the listeners on Secure Retirement Radio. You can learn how you can dramatically reduce or even eliminate taxes altogether in your retirement years with a free secured retirement tax analysis. It's fairly straightforward. Here's how it works. We're going to gather some basic information from you. We'll determine some tax saving strategies that are best suited for your specific situation. We take this information, we give it to our elves, the elves put it together, we bring it to the lab, and then we put together a customized, personalized report that was made just for you. We'll sit down with you virtually or face-to-face or however you prefer to do that these days, and we'll share the strategies with you, and we can show you exactly how much money you could be saving. The results are oftentimes very significant. Now, the analysis is free. It's only available for those of you joining us here today on Secure Retirement Radio. There's no obligation, but it's only for those of you that are concerned about taxes and want to bring this into your planning. We typically can help families that have accumulated at least $500,000 in their retirement savings, but if you have more than that, the benefits can be substantially higher. So if you'd like to schedule your complimentary secured retirement tax analysis, give us a call this morning, 952-777-8838. That's 952-777-8838. I believe we've got a very short window of time here. It's an opportunity to take advantage of some simple, straightforward tax strategies that can definitely save you. Number again, 952-777-8838.
When we come back, proven and effective ways you could reduce or even eliminate your taxes in retirement.
He's Dylan Wahlberg. I'm Joe Lucy. Don't go anywhere. More with Secure Retirement Radio in a few moments.
He's a certified financial planner, fiduciary, and a contributor to the Wall Street Journal. And he's no ordinary Joe. You're listening to Joe Lucy on Secured Retirement Radio.
Do you want to retire in the next 5 years? Who wouldn't, right? But how will you ensure that you cover all your bases so you don't overlook or underestimate anything? Learn how with the Ultimate Retirement Planning Checklist. It's free from Joe Lucy of Secured Retirement Financial in the Twin Cities. Joe's a certified financial planner.
All right. So here's the good news, bad news discussion. The good news is that 2020 is, well, 2020, it's hindsight, it's behind us. Bad news is, well, your taxes are about to go through the roof. And increasing taxes may be the fastest way that I know that you can decimate your tax deferred, these retirement accounts you set aside, and have a tremendous impact on your retirement year. So welcome back to Secure Retirement Radio. I'm Joe Lucy, certified financial planner. I got Dylan Wahlberg joining me in the St. Louis Park Secured Retirement Radio studio. And we're talking today about why massive tax increases are right around the corner, why they're in your future. Coming up in this segment, the difference between tax preparation versus tax planning and how bringing this into a retirement plan can help save you a fortune.
Yeah, we talked in the first segment this morning, Joe, on Secure Retirement Radio about reasons why taxes are going to go through the roof, why they're going to go higher in the future. And we talk about how can you defend yourself and how can you defend your retirement savings. And that's recognizing that there's a big difference between tax planning and tax preparation. And you know, being in this month of January, we know the tax forms are coming. This tax preparation time is coming up here as we approach April 15th. And that's the tax preparation is where you bring all these forms, get the shoebox, bring them into your CPA, enrolled agent, your tax preparer, whatever it is. They're going to plug it into their software. They're going to, maybe they'll find you an extra deduction or something maybe you didn't know you had, save you a couple bucks.
Well, but this year it might be some credits.
Yep, exactly, right? But they're looking backwards. They're looking at last year. It's all water under the bridge, interpreting the tax code for what was last year. And tax planning is really where you can really start to defend your retirement savings from these higher taxes in the future.
Well, all right. And I think that we oftentimes get confused about that because, you know, we're paying our tax preparers, our enrolled agents, our CPAs, good money to explore the tax code, to interpret that for us and then bring it into our return, find us an extra deduction, exclusion, exemptions. Is there a credit that we can be bringing on? That's a different discussion than what we're really having here today. You see, you're looking backwards with tax preparation. It's the year-end date of December 31st for the most part, except for maybe an extra IRA, HSA contribution or something. You're pretty much past what we can do. Look forward tax planning is about exploring how your finances are going to hit the tax return down the road. I mean, let's think about it. When's the last time you went through, pulled in your statements, brought it to your tax preparer, and went through every one of your retirement account statements? In fact, does your tax preparer even have an idea what is in that retirement account of yours? And very likely they don't. They may not even know how much is in there. unless you're already taking required distributions and they're helping you with that calculation. But for the most part, what's going to happen tax-wise is the burden has been passed on to the planning that you're doing with your financial professionals. And all too often, the financial professionals look at this planning as something that they'd rather not touch, and they push it back to the CPA. And now what we have is a situation where you've got a CPA assuming that somebody else is taking care of this, and your tax professional trying to say, well, somebody else needs to. And the only way that you can really address this is to start bringing in the tax planning early. You know, we oftentimes talk about the golden decade, Dylan, ages of 59 and a half to 70 and a half. But when should you be doing tax planning? Well, if you're listening to us this morning and you're 30, 40, 50, you need to start looking at this and seeing how we can restructure things, how we can do things. You know, one of the biggest questions we oftentimes get in our office is, should I be putting more into my Roth 401k or a traditional 401k? They're great questions, and the answer is it really depends. It's about sitting down and starting to project where your taxes are going to hit on the tax return, what kind of brackets you're in, looking at how to optimize those brackets. Somebody that's in the 12% bracket that accidentally takes on and moves too much money into a Roth and finds himself in a 22% tax bracket, well, that is an 80% increase in taxes. We don't want to be doing that. But on the other hand, if you're in a 22% bracket, maybe you do want to pay 24%. It's really not that big an increase, but it's really about sitting down, working with various professionals, looking at the taxes, looking at your personal situation, how much do you have in your retirement accounts? Yeah, very likely bringing in the other tax professionals that are doing the tax preparation so everybody's on the same page. That's the ideal situation. But if you're only focusing on how to take your money back or just on the wealth accumulation and you're not having discussions, especially with everything else going on right now, now that we have more clarity about the direction of taxes, you need to be having these discussions with the families or with the advisors that are working and helping you and your family into and through retirement.
And kind of jumping on that point about only looking at wealth accumulation, there's an article from CNBC. It says, making smart tax decisions can have a big impact on the amount of money someone has in retirement. And they go on to say that investing and withdrawing your retirement funds in a tax-efficient way is among the top ways financial advisors can boost the returns for their clients. That's according to an analysis by Morningstar. So just by withdrawing money and looking at taxes, it can increase your retirement income to up to 4%. Now, that's putting together an entire plan that concentrates on taxes. That isn't just concentrating on the wealth accumulation and the investment products to boost your income 4%. That's just looking and doing some straightforward tax planning.
I want to go back because a few minutes ago I said if you're in your 30s and 40s and 50s, early, maybe retirement's still a little bit farther down the path here, it's important to bring in tax planning. But as you get, and all of a sudden that retirement date is closer, or maybe you've already retired, you need to start looking about not just how to accumulate the wealth. You know, saving for retirement has been fairly easy. We take a certain amount of our paycheck, we have it carved out, we never even see it in many cases, goes into an account. And because of the wonders of compounding and tax deferral, these accounts have grown in many cases to large sums. Plus the market has helped us out some too, right? So we, as we're getting, when retirement's farther down the road, we focusing on our wealth accumulation as the primary strategy is the no-brainer. But as you start to transition, as you get to a point where you start thinking about how do I take this money back? That's not a, you know, income planning is different than wealth accumulation planning. How do I take the money back? How do I make it tax efficient? As Dylan was saying, Morningstar study says that proper and well planned tax planning can save you up to 4% on the returns, and that's a huge number. How do I take it back? How do I make it tax efficient? How do I make it last a lifetime? Nobody wants to run out of money before they run out of retirement, and bringing in tax planning to your strategy, the wealth accumulation that you do, is a key component to that. Now, when you start thinking about the relationship or the discussions you're having right now about your accumulation, or maybe you're doing it on your own. You've been working with 1-800 mutual fund company. You recognize that these investments are lower cost. That works well for the accumulation, but are you getting the advice about how to take your money back tax efficiently? And we're spending a lot of time on that because there's no better time to be doing it now. We have more clarity getting into 2021 here, halfway into January. We know taxes are going to be going higher. We know that they're going higher, and more than important than that, we know they're right around the corner. So many families fail to recognize that taxes are the lowest we've seen in over 40 years. So if you want to take advantage of this window of opportunity we have now, there are ways, simple defensive ways, that you can save tens of thousands, if not hundreds of thousands of dollars around taxes, but it takes a look forward tax strategy. It means that you have to bring that in to the discussions with your professionals. That's why I'd like to make you a personal offer just for the listeners on today's show here at Secure Time Radio. I want to show you, I want my team to show you how we can reduce or eliminate taxes in your retirement with a free secured retirement tax analysis. It's fairly straightforward. We gather some information. I bring it down to my labs. My lab team puts together some reports that will specifically show you ways that you can save taxes that are best suited for your customized, your personalized situation. We'll sit back down with you. We can show you exactly how much money you can save, but it's only going to be available for today's listeners. So if you'd like to take advantage of the Secured Retirement Tax Analysis, give us a call right now at 952-777-8838, 952-777-8838. You don't want to squander this short opportunity we have here to take charge of your taxes, and it involves bringing in tax.
The Euros are here, and we'd better make the most of them, because they only come around every four, 5 years. So if your bookie isn't making you feel special, then maybe it's time to find a new one. Yep, not so much carpe diem as carpa diem. If the grass is greener on the other side, come and play on it. If your bookie's not giving you the best rewards, switch, and you'll get a completely free €5 bet builder on England v Scotland this Friday. Paddy Power.
Pre-match bet builder bets only. Max one free bet and in 2+ legs on an exclusive. Must have previously deposited. T's and C's apply. Play safe. 18+ gamblingcare.ie.
This is in with the rest of the financial planning you've been doing. 952-777-8838.
When we come back, how you could reduce or potentially eliminate taxes on your IRAs and 401ks.
That's Del Mauberg. I'm Joe Lucy, Certified Financial Planner. More from Secure Retirement Radio in a few moments.
He's a certified financial planner, fiduciary, and a contributor to the Wall Street Journal. And he's no ordinary Joe. You're listening to Joe Lucy on Secured Retirement Radio.
Find us on your radio at AM 1130 and FM 103.5. Stream us on iHeartRadio. And now find us on, hey Alexa, play Twin Cities News Talk on iHeartRadio.
Getting Twin Cities News Talk station from iHeartRadio.
Thanks, Alexa.
From the Cremation Society of Minnesota Weather Center.
Free as a breeze, not to mention. Well, the writing is on the wall. Taxes for you and your family, very likely they're going higher. How soon? Very soon. Doesn't matter what side of the political fence you sit on. This is our new reality. There's stimulus and changes in administration and programs, and we're going to see higher taxes. And, you know, a lot of us are just grateful to see 2020 behind us. But 2021 is the year we need to start addressing this tax hangover. So if you're planning on retiring in the next handful of years, or maybe you've already retired, the taxes that you can pay can take a huge chunk out of your IRAs, 401ks, any of the retirement accounts you have, and they end up leaving you just a fraction of what you thought you had to be counting on going into retirement. Welcome back to Secure Retirement Radio. I'm Joe Lucy, Certified Financial Planner. We got Dylan Mauberg joining us here today in the St. Louis Park Secured Retirement Radio studio. And we're talking about why these massive tax increases, well, been discussed for years. The reality is they're right around the corner. Coming up in this segment, why your taxes on your IRAs and 401ks could end up being a lot higher than you think. Plus, we're going to talk about required minimum distributions. They're back again. And how they can make this whole situation that we've found ourselves in even worse.
Yeah, and we talked this morning about why taxes are going to have to go higher in the future. We talked about how do we start defending your retirement savings against that by utilizing tax planning and not just assuming that tax preparation is going to take care of this problem. And kind of extending on that, we look at you know, what is the taxes on these retirement accounts and these other tax-deferred accounts going to be? And you kind of mentioned this earlier, Joe. If we asked you, you know, how much do you have saved up for retirement in these IRAs, 401ks, these retirement accounts? And, you know, a lot of you might know off the top of your head. You have a number. Some of you might have to go dig in the drawer and find some, you know, last month's statements, whatever it is. Go online. But you can get to that number fairly quickly. But if we asked you, you know, how much tax are you going to pay on these retirement accounts that's due down the road sometime? I don't think that a lot of families really even have a clue on that. And that's really where these higher taxes in the future can be dangerous.
Well, keep in mind, it comes back to the number one lie that I believe we've all been told. If you're a boomer, you were told that you would set aside money into these retirement accounts. You're going to get a tax deduction when that money goes in, and it's going to reduce the amount of taxable income you pay tax on. So going back to the 1980s, 1990s, 2000, whenever you started setting aside this money, it helped out your overall tax situation at the end of that year. The tax preparer showed you how you could reduce and pay less tax. And because of the powers of compounding, because these monies have never been taxed, they've accumulated. And in many cases, you know, many of us are looking at account balances that we would have never thought we would see in these retirement accounts. The problem is, when I have this balance, if I, as you were talking about, Dylan, if I look at the statement and I say, for sake of argument, there's $1 million in this 401k. We think of this money as our money, like 100% ours, right? This is what I get to spend in retirement. But that balance is different than a balance even on a brokerage account. You know, in a brokerage account, you may have capital gains, but these are lower rates than, in most cases, than your ordinary income rates. And 100% of the money that's in an IRA has to come out, and it has to be taxed at the tax rate you're in. We think of that $1 million balance as all of ours, but we have a silent partner, and that silent partner is Uncle Sam. It's the IRS. And when we put this money aside, the promise was this: I'll take it out and it'll be at a lower bracket. And tens of thousands, that's how many people are retiring each and every year. Tens of thousands of boomers are retiring right now, and they're finding out that the lower bracket may not necessarily be the case. They're going to be paying higher tax on this money than when it even went in. And that's bad by itself. But worse, if I'm thinking I've got $1 million and this is all mine, and I ignore the tax component of this, well, then we can find ourselves in a real problem. The bigger problem is this: trillions and trillions of dollars in stimulus. A lot of you received another $600 here at the first of the year. They're talking about doing more. We got PPP2 that's going on right now. We are adding to the stimulus, $28 trillion in debt right now. We were worried when it was 20. It's now 28 trillion. And we have an administration that's promising to raise tax. Now, who? They're going to raise it on the rich, but the reality is if you're joining us here today, it's very likely that you would fall into that category. It's going to impact all Americans. We're all going to be responsible for paying for this. So when I think about the tax rate I pay on the money I withdraw, this $1 million, I have to start saying, well, what is the percentage of that that goes to the IRS? And it's a moving target. You're in a 22% bracket now. You're very likely in the 25% bracket if they go back to the old tax code. You might pay extra Medicare premiums. It's called IRMA, income related to Medicare adjustment amounts. This is a hidden tax. We don't know where taxes are going. We know that taxes are going higher, but are they going to go to 25%, or are we going to be paying 30, 35, 40? You know, David Walker, he used to be a controller general of the federal government under Reagan and Clinton, I believe. But maybe it was one of the Bushes. But he has said that, he stated that we need to see a 40% increase or go to a 40% tax bracket kind of across the board. And if that's the case, we could be getting off a lot cheaper with lower taxes today by doing a little proactive planning. Because when we don't know how much higher they're going to go, that's what gets us in trouble. Think about that, a mortgage. You have a mortgage on your house, and you know what that rate is, and many of us have maybe even refinanced and found ourselves in a lower rate than we ever would have thought we'd have seen just 10 years ago. But imagine that we get notification that that interest rate on that mortgage is going to go higher. Not by a little bit, but substantially higher. if you had a mortgage that could adjust to a higher interest rate in 5 years or 10 years or maybe even next year, you would do everything you could to divert your money into getting that property paid off as soon as you can. Well, when we have $1 million 401k balance, there's a mortgage on it. The mortgage on it is future taxes. We don't know what the taxes are going to be. So how much do you want to divert? How much should you be diverting mathematically, statistically? Let's run it through the calculators to show you how much money you should be redirecting into taking and addressing this issue. Because if you do nothing, if you're only focusing on how much return I got last year and we're not bringing in the tax planning in with the discussion around the investment strategies, well, then you're only focusing on one portion of the overall planning that you should be doing as you get ready for retirement.
Yeah, and we talk about planning for future taxes, and there's this future date of when you turn age 72 and these required minimum distributions. And yeah, age 72, the Secure Act was passed here going into effect last January 1st, 2020. Not 70 and a half anymore, it's 72. So when you get to age 72, the IRS is now going to tell you how much you have to take out of these retirement accounts, and you're going to be paying taxes at whatever the tax rate is at that future date. And you mentioned Joe, making a plan around it. Whether you're 60 today or you're 70 today, this is still in the future, and the best time to start planning around it is going to be today under today's tax code.
Thanks for joining us here today. We're on Secure Retirement Radio, and we're talking about how taxes are coming. And we're talking about how you can start to defend yourself around these strategies. The first part of this situation is we have to recognize that taxes are going higher. We need to start looking at how we can start planning and understand that tax preparation and tax planning are two different things. And as we start to get a little deeper into this, we start realizing that all of this money in our retirement accounts has never been taxed. And we need to start recognizing that it's not all ours, because if we don't, as Dylan said, what often happens is that when we retire, we've been told, you know, way back in the day, don't ever touch this money. So you retire, you find other ways, you take Social Security, you maximize your pensions, you do other things, but you do everything you can to not touch the IRAs. But then 72 hits us, and we're back to required distribution, though we didn't have that last year. And now we're going to find ourselves taking out, on average, 4%. If you're in your 80s, it's 5%, gets up to 10% of these account balances, and you're forced to take the money out. You're forced to pay whatever the tax rate, the law of the land is at that time. If I start looking out 5 or 10 years, we know the law of the land is changing. We're going to be paying higher taxes. So how much should we be looking at diverting from our current strategies into how to proactively get ourselves in a better situation? Because these RMDs can cause problems where we're paying higher Medicare premiums. These required distributions can push us into higher brackets. They can eliminate us from getting different provisions, different stimulus. We had families that are calling us saying, well, I'm not getting that $600 because of the required distribution. Most times when we visit with families for the very first time, they might even share with us that they've worked with another advisor for many years. But what brought them into our offices for a tax analysis is oftentimes because they recognize that they really have not done very much when it comes to bringing in tax planning with their investment strategies. Now, don't take it wrong. Investment strategies are very important. You know, somebody that didn't that lost money last year after everything that was going on, you may want to readdress your investment strategies. However, if all you're focusing on is how much you can get that account balance to, the IRA balance, ignoring the fact that somewhere down the road you're going to have to take out required distributions, well, then you're missing a major component of your tax planning. And what I'd like to do is I'd like to invite you into a discussion or second opinion with one of our advisors. Because if you've got that IRA or 401k, you may think of it as all your money, but you really have a joint account. It's an IRA account. It's a retirement account between you and the IRS. And you could end up paying a whole lot more unnecessarily in taxes on these accounts than you even know. So the advantage of having a simple tax planning strategy today ends up saving you tens of thousands, if not hundreds of thousands of dollars down the road. And it's really about how do we divert certain strategies, how do we be proactive with our planning. And if you aren't having the discussion, then you're on somebody else's program, right? So you can discover how to reduce, eliminate taxes on IRAs, 401ks. You have a thrift savings plan, you have a 403b plan. We can show you how we can do that with a free customized secured retirement tax analysis. It's fairly simple. We just need to gather some information. I'll bring it to my lab. We'll put it through and we'll put together a personalized, this is not a cookie cutter report. This is a personalized report. Sometimes we get a phone call. Hey, can you send us that report? I can't do the report. You need to schedule some time so we can go through this because it's personalized. And then we'll sit down with you and we'll show you specific strategies on how you can save money, defensive strategies, and we'll show you exactly what that savings could be. So you can make an intelligent decision. The analysis is free. There's no obligation. It's only going to be for today's listeners on Secure Retirement Radio. So if you'd like to schedule your Secure Retirement Tax Analysis, give us a call right now, 952-777-8838. That's 952-777-8838. Don't squander the opportunity we have here. We got a short period of time before taxes go through the roof. 952-777-8838.
When we come back, most people never see it coming, but if you're not careful, you could pay taxes on up to 85% of your Social Security income.
He's Del Malberg. I'm Joe Lucy. Don't go anywhere. More with Secure Retirement Radio.
He's a certified financial planner, fiduciary, and a contributor to the Wall Street Journal. And he's no ordinary Joe. You're listening to Joe Lucy on Secured Retirement Radio.
Glenn Beck, weekdays from 9 to 11 on Twin Cities News Talk AM 1130 and 103.5 FM.
And if you think that these words mean nothing, you're wrong.
And on iHeartRadio with your smart speaker.
Do you want to retire in the next 5 years? Who wouldn't, right? But how will you ensure...
Welcome back to Secured Retirement Radio. We're talking this morning about massive tax increases, and we all know they're right around the corner. Now, some people are going to think that these taxes are only going to impact the wealthy, but given the significant consequences and everything that we've gone through, what was necessary here to work through the COVID-19 and the stimulus that's been created, it's not just the wealthy. It's going to be all of us hardworking Americans that are going to have to pay up and pay off some of this $28 trillion in debt. Now, if you're ready to retire in the next 5 years, that's problematic because the increases could be hitting you at a time when you least need it. And the devastating impact that it can do on your savings, it could be monumental. So welcome back to Secure Retirement Radio. I'm Joe Lucy, Certified Financial Planner. I got Dylan Malberg joining me. We're talking today about massive tax increases that are no longer just a theory, but they are now right around the corner. Coming up in our final segment here, we're going to talk about some little-known strategies that can help you avoid being taxed on up to 85% of your Social Security income and why you need to make sure that you're planning around Social Security and how this fits in with the overall strategies that you are using to retire securely.
Yeah, we talk about taxes on these Social Security benefits, and you know, you generally ask the question and you say, you know, is Social Security income taxable? And you know, the first answer is yes. Now, generally it is taxable, but whether or not you're actually going to pay taxes on your Social Security, that is going to depend on other sources of income that are hitting your 1040.
Families are oftentimes surprised, Dylan, when we're sitting down together, when I explain to them that if the only income that they needed to live on in retirement, because of the calculations, which we're going to not be able to get into this morning, but we'll share that with you when you join us in the office for your review. Because of the calculations, if somebody had $60,000, $70,000 of Social Security income, and that's all they needed in retirement, they would never pay another tax return. They'd never have to pay any more taxes on this money. Now, you know, when you start thinking about other sources of income, let's say we had other income from Roth IRAs. Well, guess what? That's not taxable. It doesn't go in the calculation, so you wouldn't have to worry about it. How about other tax-free sources like municipal bonds? Well, municipal bonds do go towards that. So you want to make sure you're working with somebody that can tell you this kind of income, how this works, this kind of income, how it doesn't. Now, just because you have a pension doesn't mean that this all goes away, because if there's ways you can deduct the pension, you know, you got a standard deduction above $24,000, you can also mitigate some of this. But if you're only doing planning right now, and your decision is, well, I want to take Social Security right away so I don't lose it. I need to see how much I can get from my income. You're not paying attention to the tax benefit or the tax, the way that Social Security is can be beneficial. If you're not looking at ways to reposition, being proactive, like we've been talking about here, to avoid paying unnecessary taxes down the road, you'll end up paying a lot more in Social Security than somebody that's done some planning here.
And we talk about, you know, tax efficiency of income. We talked about it earlier. We, again, Joe, you wrote the book on Social Security. We are big proponents on optimizing Social Security, not by just, you know, getting the most out of it, but making sure it's going to go into your overall plan for income. How does it relate to taxes, the investments? How is everything going to work together to overall ultimately optimizing your Social Security benefits?
You know, a lot of times, Dylan, somebody says, well, Joe, why is it that you're the only one ever talking about this? And I think that it's because we aren't looking in the right places. If you're looking on how to optimize your taxes and Social Security, you can't go to the Social Security Administration. They aren't tax preparers. They aren't even financial planners. They can't give you advice around how the tax impact is going to work. If you're looking at your person that's doing your taxes, they might only be looking at things in the rearview mirror. If you're working with an investment advisor that only does investments, they probably haven't been schooled in this. According to CNBC, deciding when you claim your Social Security could be one of the most important financial decisions that you will make in your lifetime. We talk a lot about mailbox income. It's money that hits the checkbook each and every month. And on top of that, it can be very tax efficient. You know, you've set aside money into this. There's hundreds of thousands of dollars of income that could be at stake here. And that's why I'd like to make a special offer here as we close out today's show of Secure Retirement Radio just for you that have joined us today. I want to show you how you can get even more income, more net income, when you file your Social Security with a customized Social Security analysis. The analysis doesn't cost you a dime. It's free. And in this, what you will learn is this: the optimal time, the time and date that you should be looking at taking your benefits. We can show you how to reduce or even eliminate paying taxes up to 85% of the benefit income you get. We'll show you how to prevent your Social Security decision from unnecessarily or unknowingly doubling Medicare premiums. Plus, if you're eligible for other benefits, we're going to make sure that you walk away with that information as well. If you have not filed for Social Security and you've been joining us here on Secure Retirement Radio, call right now and get a free customized Social Security analysis, what we call the Secure Retirement Analysis, Social Security Analysis, at 952-777-8838. Because the difference between the best case and worst case scenarios can literally mean hundreds of thousands of dollars of additional income. It all hinges on how, when, and the taxes around your Social Security. Number is 952-777-8838. That's all we have time for this morning. I hope everybody enjoys the rest of your weekend, and we'll be back next Saturday with more from Secure Retirement Radio.
He's a certified financial planner, fiduciary, and a contributor to the Wall Street Journal. And he's no ordinary Joe. You're listening to Joe Lucy on Secure Retirement Radio.
AM 1130.